Yo, what's going on, everyone? Brian and Jim here with Drink a Beer and Play a Game, and today we're presenting the worst NES golf title. It's Greg Norman's Golf Power.
Released in 1992, this was developed by Gremlin Interactive and published by Virgin. It's another licensed golf game for the NES. Somehow there are a few of these, and I don't know why. Anyway, let's see if it's worth the eternal legacy of one Greg Norman who has a lot of golf power. I'm sorry.
When looking at the graphics, you've heard me say this a million times, but considering how late in the NES life cycle this was, this game could have looked a hell of a lot better. Now, we will give credit. The sprite for Greg Norman looks pretty good, but the rest of the game is a pixelated mess. It doesn't really matter which course you choose. It doesn't begin to look better at any point, and it's just an eyesore. We did appreciate that they added in little effects for the rain or the wind, and the minimap is actually one of the better looking ones from the NES, but still, it should have been looking a hell of a lot better. So as you see from our scores, I gave it a 4 and Jim gave it a 3. As far as beers, starting us off with 3 beers. This is just unacceptable.
Speaking of unacceptable, where the fuck is the music? Oh, yeah, we're doing sound now, by the way. Al, I'm sorry, but it's 1992. How do you have a game without sound in it? Well, music.
Hey, Jim.
What? What now?
Maybe they were going for the sound of silence.
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
Sometimes I wish we did this in video form so you could see the look on my face right now. Anyway, god fucking damn it. There is some sound effects in the game, but I mean, it's you whacking the ball. Just whacking away. Just on the green, all to yourself.
Stop saying whacking! I know you're about to say it.
Getting your strokes off. Anyway, there's almost nothing here. Bri gave it a 1, I gave it a 2, solely for the somewhat decent yet short menu screen music. And that's it. As far as beer, I'm gonna add 3 beers, each for the piece of my soul I lost by playing this game without music.
All the NES golf titles had almost identical control. It was more or less a meter that you power up, and you hit the button for when you want to give it the power, and then you have to center it from, you know, slicing the ball or centering the ball. We were pretty much used to them all. And then comes along this goddamn game. This one has the added bonus of when you hold down the A button, you have to hold the direction pad to power it up. Sounds like a minor inconvenience, but when you're a couple beers deep and you're playing through all these shitty golf games, it's a real annoyance. Once you do get used to it, it's semi-acceptable. You really need to play it to just see how annoying it is. Sometimes your finger can just slip. Things can happen. And when things like that can really screw up your gameplay experience, that's a bunch of bullshit. So we both gave it 4s. Yes, it becomes almost average when you do get used to it, but like I said, it's still an annoyance, and you had one fucking job, Control. Way to fuck it up. When it comes to beer, 2 beers, just because.
So when it comes to options, derp!
Hey, how about you talk about gameplay?
Shut up. So when it comes to gameplay, this game does give you a lot of options. You get to set what course you want to play on. You want to get to set what type of level of player you are. You can even design your own courses. You can put weather effects in. It gives you a whole lot from a purely simulation standpoint. Problem is, the game isn't fucking fun. It plays like most other golf games, but it's got that poppin' for all the courses that takes forever. The game's just lags. It doesn't draw you in because of no music. It doesn't engage you at all, and by like the third hole, you're just bored of the game. Maybe functionally overall, it's perfectly fine, kinda? But with the odd control choices and just the overall lack of anything going on, I couldn't give it any more than a 3. In fact, neither could Brian. So, we gave it 3s. And that sounds like a good number, so I'll add that to the number of beers. 1 for being able to design your own course, 1 for all the options, and 2 for no goddamn music! I'm so goddamn still angry about that! How can I whack without music?
Damn it! While we might have shit on this game's presentation, control, and gameplay, this game comes with a ton of originality. Jim kind of touched on it, but the fact that you can design your own course in this game, set the weather, just the sheer number of options, a lot of the other golf games were not offering at the time. So it was something that when we turned on, we had high hopes. I mean, just look at this menu option. It's insane how many things you can choose from. But we're not going to beat a dead horse. You know what happens once you actually start playing the courses. So we actually gave it 8s. We really respect the fact that they put a lot of time into making this a more immersive game, but it just was not fun. And as far as beer, you're pretty drunk right now, but add 2 more to that meter. That's right, fuckers.
So, replayability. Yeah, with all the options this game gives you that we talked about before, you can make this basically any experience you want. You can play multiplayer, you can design your own courses. So, you can come back, make any course you want, have a different gameplay experience every goddamn time. Almost an infinite amount of, really, courses you can play thanks to that. So, we had no choice but to give it 10s. It gives you every option in the book to really make it your own game. Too bad it's boring. And when it comes to beer, you don't need any. This game has some of the best replayability I've ever seen.
Pussy!
Shut up! You shut up! I'm whacking.
So overall, like the last time, this was a no-brainer to choose as the worst NES golf title. It had amazing ideas and a ton of replayability, but none that could make it fun. Think back to games like Excitebike, where you could create your own course, even if you got tired of the regular game. Some of the fun of that title was just making ridiculous courses and playing with your buddies. We didn't even have the will to want to try to do that with each other, because the basic courses suck so bad that... I'm getting off track. This game was terrible. If you're a hardcore golf fan, you might like this game a little more, but then you gotta be real with yourself. This game sucks. So, we both gave it a 2. There's really no excuse for this game and all of its flaws, and when we combined all of our scores together, it gets a 3.6. This is one of the lowest scores we've given out in a while, so congratulations, Greg Norman. You really sucked a dick on this one. When it comes to beer pairing, we decided we needed to pick a beer from Down Under because that's where Greg Norman's from, so we had to go with Foster's. Listen, we know when you think Australian beer, you think of Foster's, but if you've ever actually tried it, it's really not that good. It just comes in an oversized can. So, get a few of these cans if you really want to waste your time, play this game. But remember to drink your beers and play your games responsibly. As always, guys, thanks for checking out this video. And if you enjoyed it, make sure you give us a thumbs up, leave some comments, or better yet, why not subscribe? Till next time, guys. Cheers.